People have questions. People have concerns.
In the days since the derailment, crews have been cleaning the accident site. People are back home. But many of the same questions remain.
Is the air safe? Is it safe for my child to come back home? Is it safe for my mom, my grandparent, to come back home? Is it safe for my pets to come back home?
Sarah Burnett is a toxicologist with CTEH, an environmental consulting firm. She's one of dozens of scientists in East Palestine helping answer those questions about air quality.
So what do you say to them? What is that answer?
I say to them that we have detected no vinyl chloride or other constituents related to this incident in the air, and that all of our air monitoring and sampling data collectively do not indicate any short or long-term risks to them, their children, or their families.
CTEH has decades of experience handling toxicology and environmental health issues in communities around the country, working with a variety of government services and businesses. They started testing the air in East Palestine within hours of the derailment, and that testing has continued every day throughout the day since then, with two types of air monitoring. Real-time air monitoring includes using these handheld devices to test air quality all over the community, from schools and libraries to homes. And these stationary devices placed at the outskirts of the derailment site do real-time monitoring too, pulling readings every 15 seconds. Then there's analytical air sampling, where data is gathered over the course of 24 hours before it gets sent to a lab. They've collected hundreds of thousands of data points, giving them the confidence to say the air is safe. For questions about the air, there's a number that will get you to a toxicologist, and you can also call for air monitoring at your home.